Cumpleaños feliz, cumpleaños feliz, cumpleaños, cumpleaños, cumpleaños feliz.
Brittany Lovewell is a hyper-competitive ballroom dancer.
Big smiles or we'll lose.
She wants to win.
Yes.
Is it believable that he would leave me for her? I'm just asking. I love being called the evil twin. Brittany's noticing that Gabby is kind of a favorite, and that's not cool.
Once again, it's Gabby, Gabby, Gabby.
We got beef. Oh no, Gabby, come back. I think playing evil is the most fun I've ever had. See, Mark?
Brittany?
Yeah, babe?
I'm sorry, but we're done.
What? But as long as you love to hate them.
Like, I think I loved him, you know?
There is nobody like Anna Grace Barlow.
You need like another color, because I could do one that's like ragey.
Brittany is so horrible and so mean.
She's the worst.
And Anna Grace is so nice.
Who is most likely to make people laugh during a scene? Anna Grace.
What's your favorite dance movie?
I don't know. My mom says that movie theaters are for people who can't afford air conditioning.
Is Brittany a mean girl or a wounded soul?
I think she's definitely a wounded soul. I think there's much more to Brittany than meets the eye.
I was bullied in ballet class when I was little.
You were bullied?
By the whole class.
Man.
After I bullied each of them individually, they banded together.
Well, Anna Grace, my gosh. Today is finally that day. 2 days later than initially planned, but hey, better late than never. I know it was your Ricky Red 20th birthday on Sunday, and I was always going to do it on your real birthday, but Mother Nature had other plans and decided to, like, fuck it up like Fabrizio goddamn Roberto. So we had to push it to today, considering I was already busy yesterday, despite, you know, the weather cleaning up its shit the second half of yesterday, so... Today is the day. I figured today would be appropriate since it's going to be nice all day no matter what. And we're going to Dairy Queen with work, so I wanted to, like, you know, showcase that on camera and then do the rest of the usual neighborhood shenanigans as always. So, therefore, we're going to have a banger belated birthday celebration just for your Ricky Red 28th birthday. And, we're going to have a banger celebration for you 2 days late for your Ricky Red 28th birthday and some fucking hell of a good old fashioned, so it's gonna be one rager celebration that you won't wanna miss. So let's get this fiesta started. Brittany Lovewell started. It's Brittany, Brittany, let me try that again. Let's get this fiesta started, Brittany Lovewell style. It's Brittany, bitch. All right, I ended up taking another one of those lounge naps just to wake myself up, cause I was like, kind of semi half asleep, but now I'm fucking wide awake and feeling as good as ever. So in a little bit, we'll be heading to Dairy Queen for a lunch and ice cream trip. You know, it's fun in the sun season too, so why the fuck not? And plus, we're celebrating your birthday, Ricky Rod's 20th birthday, 2 days late. And then after we come home, after we come back to the day program, we're gonna throw it. Not right now, but after we come back from day program, we're gonna throw it to commercial because we got the best Anna Grace Barlow compilation as our one and only commercial break. Sadly, a long time ago to prepare for this. I did look for some Lisa Levine clips from the Goldberg, but sadly I could not find any, but I do have some of the best Brittany Lovewell clips I can find, so you will see that after the Dairy Queen trip, so let's get the fuck back out there and get ready for the trip. Alright, Anna Grace and friends, we made it, so let's go check it out like Kevin LePage. Alright, we've officially made it inside the DQ. This is our second trip of the season. First that we were here for Spring Is in the Air, which I think was off camera, but today on camera for Anna Grace Barlow's jumbo size birthday tribute, we're here on camera, so therefore, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna order the second time I get to try the food, you know, because the first time I was here was my first time in 20 years trying to get savings before, and then of course after that my vanilla ice cream, so it's gonna be one hell of a killer trip. Would you look at that? This is how old I was last year. Kirk Shelmerdine, 27. Just one off my age this year. Ricky Red, 28, which is Anna Grace Barlow's age as of this video.
So, even though I'm a picky eater, it doesn't look like I need that, because look at that. I asked for ketchup, and that's what they gave me. I don't know if it's Heinz, but hey, it's better than no ketchup at all. So, everybody dig in like Dick Trickle.
I mean, half the first piece of chicken is already gone.
Hey,
After we finish this up, we're going to be ordering vanilla ice cream afterwards. We're going to tear that shit up like Jerry Labonte. I guess I got a little paranoid anyway and decided to use the Heinz ketchup just to be on the safe side. So, better safe than sorry, as I always say. Hey, let me fix the camera. A little bit. Yeah, that's better.
You pay for the dinner before.
The reversal now. You gotta pay for the reversal now. We're talking about the wedding in the back. Like Kevin and Melanie.
Ma, are you happy to meet? Ma.
I'm busy.
Yeah.
All right, here it is, ladies and gentlemen. The protein is done, so therefore it's time for all the good stuff, like the good treats. You know, it's junk food, but it's also good. Not to mention, I was also making friends with the young man at the front desk and stuff. I mean, it's great.
Oh, wait a minute, what am I doing? To Anna Grace Barlow for her Ricky Rudd 28th birthday. I know we couldn't celebrate Sunday because it rained and I ended up sleeping through the New England 300, but 2 days later, you know, better late than never. So cheers to one of my ultimate favorite actresses. Here's another one. Here's to many more years, decades, and centuries with her partner in crime, Andrew Colicchio. All right, brain freeze. Oh my God. We're gonna continue our adventures off camera when we get back to the day program and beyond. So we'll meet you, you know, when we go home and, you know, do all the neighborhood shenanigans to celebrate. But if anything exciting happens to us today here at work, we'll break in and show it to you. But for now, enjoy the best of Britney Lovewell clips I can find throughout the interwebs. Well, that's, you know, this one and only very special edition commercial break. So we'll be back in a minute.
And Britney brings the fire. 1, 2, swat, swat, boom, 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 boom.
Yes.
And dip again.
Maybe bring it down 40%.
It only goes up.
You're gonna pay for this.
Pay for what? You're the one who got drunk, dummy.
Still, this isn't over. I'm still the white swan.
Hey, Brittany, what's up?
Oh my God, are you following me? Quit stalking me, you stalker. You're freaking me out.
Oh no, Gabby, come back.
There she is. There's my baby girl.
Mommy, what are you doing here?
Well, I thought I'd take you out for a little late night snack. I shouldn't have made that crack about your eating. I'm sorry.
Oh, thank you.
I just thought maybe we could, you know, we could catch up and talk about this next opportunity. You want to have a girls' cheat night? Maybe share some nachos and Chardonnay?
I mean, that sounds great.
Doesn't it? Extra cheese.
Wait, Mommy, no.
Excuse me?
I appreciate the invitation, but I really need to get home and get some rest before the show tomorrow. And also, Orlando is not right for me, and I don't want to do it.
Honey, we just talked about this. We both decided that this is a great opportunity for us.
Right, for you. But, you know, for me, it's a step back.
I see. I'm holding you back.
No, that's not what I meant.
No, message received, loud and clear. After all of the recitals and the competitions, talking you through the stage fright and the tears. So much for levels against the world, right?
Mommy.
And believe you me, baby girl, the world is always against the Lovewells. That is the curse that I have been protecting you from for your whole life, but no more. So tomorrow, when you look out into that crowd and you have that little pit in your stomach, don't look for me to cheer you on. Don't look for Mommy to save you from this cursed world, because I certainly don't want to hold you back.
It's not like that, Mommy. Wait, Mommy, come back. Mommy!
Now, the last question is for Brittany.
I never approved the question for Brittany. Who changed my script? Hey, Wayne, let's get out of this question and throw to the Motown package. Copy that, please.
And being so accomplished and blessed with such incredible genes from your mother's side, how and where do you find your inspiration?
Well, I'm inspired by my mother and by Simon, of course. But I've been really impressed with my new friend, Gabby. Yeah, she's a young woman. She had to give up on her dream because she had a baby with her high school teacher, and her resilience is really inspiring to me. Love you, Gabs.
What the hell is wrong with you, girl?
How could you say that?
Did you know about that?
No, I swear, I didn't know about this. Why would you say that?
Girl, what is your issue?
That's messed up.
Okay, I really don't like calling other women a bitch, but what a bitch!
Student-teacher relationship? We had a whole meeting about this.
I know.
We were not going to talk about this. What do we do?
Hey, guys, let's see if Gabby wants to respond.
Gabby, would you like to respond?
Yeah, I would. Thank you.
Brittany, that was not your secret to tell. You know, there is a reason you don't have any friends. You are a vain, scared, lonely person who needs to tear others down to seem interesting.
All I did was answer the question. Oh, I didn't know I wasn't allowed to speak Gabby's truth. I'm sorry.
Oh, who threw that? That was a stop!
What are you guys doing?
Brittany, you don't do that! You don't, no, I just want to talk to her! Do you understand me?
Should we go to a Motown?
No, not yet. Stay on Brittany. Now, give me Gabby.
You're making it
worse. Find Justin for me. I need a reaction shot of Reggie.
No.
Guys, Miriam's down. Now I need a wide of the cast, guys. I need a wide of the cast. There you go. Hey, cue up the Motown package, but you wait for my word. Hear me?
Really feels like it's time to go to Motown.
I'm fine.
Okay, everybody, she's good.
Oh,
she's
yeah,
good.
She's good, everybody.
She's fine. Okay, let's go to Motown.
Welcome back to Anna Grace Barlow's jumbo-sized birthday tribute. Yeah, that's the only commercial break you're getting. The best Brittany Lovewell clips I could find across the interweb. So we're back at home in Sandy Ridge. You're ready to knock out this celebration that should have happened 2 fucking days ago if Mother Nature wouldn't have, you know, been on her shit, you know, having me a fucking monsoon over here all goddamn day. But today, I mean, yesterday we already had a commitment, you know, regardless of what Garra Action used to throw it where we initially had in mind, but that's why I moved it to today. So therefore, it's going to get done today. It's going to get uploaded today. And if you haven't watched my collaboration with Nick Netto, Reyzorz, that he uploaded this morning while at work, go check it out. Like Kevin LePage, link is in the description. So from now on, instead of like shaving before I go out in the summer months, starting, you know, this, you know, began effective yesterday, we're going to do it after we park the bus. That way we shower, the shower blends in with our shave because it feels more refreshing that way. So we'll do the mini chores, still do the mini chores before going outdoors like normal, but we'll shave after the fact. So that way, in case someone like Brindley shows up when we go out, where is already here by the time we come home from work, that way we're not rushing to go out to see them. You know, someone that we love that we don't get to see all the time. That's our friend now that we don't get to see all the time. That way we can have more time to visit with them, especially since Brindley's leaving for college, you know, in the fall, not here in Ohio, but all the way to the West Coast in Utah. So let's do our mini chores and then I'll off camera and I'll meet you all outside to like continue this banger celebration for one of the greatest actresses of all time, Anna Grace Barlow, for her Ricky Rudd 28th birthday. So the birthday celebration has officially begun 2 days late. So, but I only took one lap around the block because it's fucking hot as balls out here, which is why I stopped to get a drink so I don't dehydrate and overheat in this, you know, scorching heat. Either we're gonna have a good time celebrating tonight, even though it's 2 days late. What, but inclement weather on the real birthday on Sunday, but as they always say, better late than never. All right, well, at least we got some fuel in our system. That way we don't fucking pass out or risk passing out and overheating and dehydrating in this scorching fucking weather. So therefore, what's going to be the first stop of this little birthday celebration? And are we going to get anyone to wish her happy birthday? Well, let's find out. And in other news, it's official. NASCAR has officially announced that the Chicago Street Course in one of the most dangerous cities in all of America is officially going to happen starting next season. Now, as someone who's not really all that passionate about the sport anymore, oh shit, look out. As someone who's not really all that passionate about the sport anymore, as in like how much I want to watch, considering, you know, as I've discussed 100 million times, my passion went from up here to down here, especially now as I've gotten older as of last year. I have found better stuff to do and bigger priorities, especially when the weather's good like this, you know? What was I saying? I lost my train of thought. Even though that's the case, I like to give new things a chance instead of like bitching about it, thinking that it's gonna be automatically bad no matter what just because it's not what it used to be when I was growing up. Sure, it's okay to feel that way. You know, you don't like how, you know, your favorite things are now as opposed to how it was when you were a child, but basically, you know, based on how old I am. But it's like they're adding new tracks, you know, stuff like that. Although, to be fair, I used to be one of those fans when I was younger because, of course, when you're younger, you have a different mindset when you're younger as opposed to, you know, being an adult. Therefore, I did bitch about new things when I was younger because I wished, you know, little me wished everything could stay the old way forever. But, you know, times change and so does, you know, the culture of sports and whatnot. You know, not just the Spurs culture. We've known that past 3 years, but NASCAR culture has changed. You know, sure, it's okay to not, you know, for, you know, most people, not just me, and I've encountered NASCAR Twitter, to not like watch it every week anymore, or not watch much at all anymore, because of how good it is. But I don't care if you still watch every week or not. You just, I like to like give new. I like to give new things. You know, NASCAR since this new modern generation has been thinking outside the box and trying new things, and I applaud it. So that's why, just like I did with the clash at the Coliseum, that's what I did. I gave it a chance and I liked it. I mean, there was something else they tried. Oh yeah, the Bristol Dirt Race the year before. This year was the Coliseum. I gave it a chance. I liked it. Last year, they introduced the Bristol Dirt Race. I gave it a chance. I liked it. So I'm noticing a trend in pattern. So 2023, if I'm lucky to watch the Chicago Street Course, you know, as long as, you know, me wanting to do better things doesn't come up, which probably highly unlikely, I might as well watch that just to see how it goes, and I might like it. You know, as my mom and dad taught me growing up a child, you never know until you try. So it goes for food. You can't love it or hate it until you try it. And it's the same thing for your favorite show. I'm not talking about like the iconic classics like Jeopardy and Wheel of Fortune. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the shows that we're growing up with now on ABC, CBS, Fox, Nickelodeon, Disney Channel. Like, if one of your favorite characters, you know, the actor that you got used to ends up, you know, who, you know, got replaced as in that character's role, or if a new actor his or her own character comes up and replaces the character that had that, you know, same occupation as the new character, you know, for example, Mike Wade, you know, came in and took, you know, his character on SEAL Team before, you know, they moved that shit to Paramount Plus, took over Judd Lorman's, you know, Blackburn role, you know, where Blackburn used to do on SEAL Team that Mike Wade's character does now. And before I stopped watching that show because they moved to kick it off CBS for some fucking reason, I gave him a chance and I liked him. And when I told Mike Wade that on Twitter, he still was very flattered. He's like, that's very nice of you, nice of your folks to tell you that. You know, it's nice you used it on me. Yeah, Judd Lorman is a legend. I will give him his props. And he knew Anna Akana, so I mentioned I was a big fan of hers. And he did say, I quote unquote, yeah, Mark, I agree. Anna Akana is awesome. And damn right she is, even though this is a different ball video about a different Anna. Or how about when Liam got, you know, Anthony Bologna got replaced as Liam by Mattia Castrillo. I gave him a chance and I liked him. Maybe if I was younger, sure, I would have had a different outlook on stuff like this, but I really don't care anymore. But, well, who's another actor that got replaced? Oh yeah, didn't Jada Owens get replaced as, you know, Shanice's daughter? Oh yeah, Shanice's daughter, you know, got replaced by Jada Owens, got replaced by another black child actor, child actress, and Melody. Yeah, Melody was her name. Melody was her name. I didn't mean to bring race into it, but I haven't talked about a million little things since the season ended this past year, so I had to like remember it off the top of my head. I gave her a chance and I liked her. You see, you know, if your favorite character on your favorite show, or at least one of them, you know, and you like their actor, but all of a sudden the actor leaves and they get replaced as the same character, it's like you never know you can't love them or hate them until you actually give them a shot. It's the same thing when, you know, they rebooted Double Dare, but didn't have Mark. Even though they still had Mark Summers there, they didn't have him as host. They had Liza Koshy. We decided to give her a shot, the YouTube chick, as we all know. And we ended up liking her. Or 2021. 3 years later, they rebooted Las Leyendas del Templo, even though that wasn't a Nickelodeon, which makes sense because it's a reboot for adults, not kids. And instead of bringing Kirk Fogg back, they let him come back for a couple of times, but they had Cristela Alonso host the reboot instead of Kirk Fogg, and I gave Cristela a chance, and guess what? We liked her. You know, this is what most people need. You know, NASCAR, this is the mindset and mentality NASCAR fans that want to live in the past need to have. I get you do not like change to your favorite sport and sometimes your favorite show, but a change is part of life, and sometimes it's not always that bad. I know most of the time it sucks, but every once in a while, you got to admit, it's kind of good for the soul every now and then, if you know what I mean. But yeah, so regardless if if my passion for NASCAR ever goes up again, like it was on Lenore and Sandhurst,
That's going to be a pull-on miracle out the ass. That's going to be a pull-on miracle out the ass. But if it does, then I'll probably watch every race again. But as of now, no. Unless it's like cold outside during the fall, winter months. And if it's raining during any time of the year, whether even in the summer, then you might as well. So anyway, we're going to go take another break. Not a commercial, but another drink break, because it's fucking hot out here. Plus, ain't nobody out here at the moment. So therefore, we haven't seen any excitement yet, but we'll just have to wait and see. But anyway, let's go get another drink. All right, I just drank another whole-ass Gatorade bottle off camera this time. So two of them should be perfectly enough to get us through the celebration without overheating, dehydrating, and risk of passing out. So anyway, so far, ain't nobody out here. At least not yet. At least not yet. I know Peanut Butter Lady and Barbecue Man just went somewhere. They were dressed up, so they must have been going somewhere. That fucking fancy. Oh, shit. Who could that be? Oh, it's just Megan. I'm Megan on the back straight away. So not Zane's aunt, you know, Andy's wife. Not that Megan. No. There's so many people with the same name around here. It's fucking hilarious. At least the sun right now is hiding behind the clouds and cooling things off a little bit. Not much, but a little bit. Someone's coming. Oh, we're not going to be able to see who that is in time. God damn it. Oh, and the Beals are there. Oh, yeah, that was Mallory's birthday. I think it was her Harvick 29th or Jeff Green 30th, one of the RCR cars, but I don't see the black Chevy there, so therefore, we can't stop over to say happy birthday now because he ain't there.
Look at that, it's just good old Bobby working in the garage, so no Mallory, no Mama Michelle today, at least for now.
And also, I have this terrible feeling, you know, I know it's been a while in between cutscenes, but it's fucking dead out here today. It's like, what the fuck? Hell, we haven't seen Mo since 4th of July. It's like crazy. I wonder who that chick is. God damn. But anyway, okay, so in other news, you know the Marshall from current sixth season of Bunked? Well, his actor Tom Rivera just friended me while I was out here. And so I have this horrible feeling that this birthday jumbo-sized birthday tribute isn't going to be as jumbo-sized as I thought it was going to be. Well, what do we have at the Beals? Is that Mallory's car? Might be. It might be. Could be Mama Michelle's, but we're going to go check it out like Kevin LePage.
As we've gotten closer, it's actually Michelle's, so never mind.
But we love her too, so we're going to go visit with her. That's just like we always do when she's around.
Stay there, little one. I had to save you once last year. I'm not going to do that again. Mama Michelle's in the house tonight.
I can check it. I've been running back and forth. I figured
it. You have a low, huh?
How long you got on the chicken?
Probably. Bob ass cooking barbecue chicken. Yeah, stay there. I don't know how the fuck to say it in Spanish. Go. Ale, ale, ale. I don't think he's gonna listen to that.
Go.
Wrong way. Turn it around. There he goes.
Okay, I think they went to go eat dinner, so let's get the hell out of here. All right, there's nothing to see going back that way, at least not anymore. So, like it was back in the good old days, before modern times took over this neighborhood. Even though, to be fair, I do like these modern times in Sandy Ridge a whole lot better than what we used to have, because I've been a lot happier. I've been surrounding myself with better people who have invited me to do stuff with them, because most of the OG neighbors that are gone, but mostly most of them still stay relevant with all the family and close friends that are still here, and that they stay with that, of course, they allow us to keep in touch with them on Facebook and such, and any kind of social media in general. What was I saying? Most of them barely did anything with me. I mean,
Very few of them did. Very few of them did. Like, I'll give you an example. Like, when Jamie, the British lady who I was crazy about and still am even to this day, was there. When her daughter Megan was way a lot littler. See, so yeah, they invited, well, to do, oh, she invited, I think they both invited me to a Megan's birthday party, to be fair. And for being fair, I think they both invited, I think it was just one or the other. There was both of them and invited us. And of course we came, although that was back when my passion for NASCAR was still up here. I was fine with coming to the party, but I still wanted to watch the NBNA Platinum 400. So I watched part of it over there. And then when it was time for me to come home, I ran into my office and smashed a studio area when it was actually much cleaner back then, and decided, you know, finish it out over there. Even though Austin ended up driving through some debris from a late race caution, you know, crash, you know, late race crash, but it caused a caution, it caused a hole in the radiator. Ty was part-time at 33 at that time, if y'all remember. Dating back to the early days of my YouTube. Oh, shit. Anzo, let's go check this out, like Kevin LePage. Okay, never mind. That wasn't as important as it normally is because, you know, Caden's point of view that we've done videos in collaboration with so far this summer. Unfortunately, the guy who's in control of that channel, his dad, has COVID. So I had to get this. So, you know, hell, even Abby's dad, you know, Fireball Man. Of course, it's the parents of the children I've done YouTube videos and collaborations with that has it, because go fucking figure. But anyway, praying, you know, wishing them both a speedy recovery, you know, Aiden's dad, of course, Abby's dad, Fireball Man. So drop your well wishes in the comments below. Get well, Steve, aka Fireball Man, and get well, Dave, you know, Caden, the father of Caden's point of view. So, man. I guess my possible soon-to-be future co-workers at ViaCourse wasn't kidding around when, or even Holly yesterday off-camera, when they said it was spiking back up again. Hopefully it's okay, I've heard stories of it spiking back up before, but then after that it calmed back down again like nothing happened. Like it would never happen. We never heard about it again after a while, so meaning that the spike up was just a minimal. Actually, if anything, I think this spike up is a little more, way more minimal now that it's like, I'm busy. I think that this spike up is a little bit more minimal than it was, you know, when it was spiking up last winter. Like, because when it's cold out, stuff like that tends to go up faster. You know, when it's colder weather, but when it's warm out, it's like, it doesn't go as fast. You know what I'm saying? You know, usually, you know, when it's warm, it helps it, but when it's cold, it hurts it. So, do you remember Brianna Paige Arsement-Barnhart's birthday tribute? I'm too lazy to put a flashback in there, so go check that out, like Kevin LePage, link in the description. I need to do a better job at putting these links of stuff in these video descriptions. I really do. Yeah, so that was when we tried to do Jerry Springer Man's birthday TikTok, but one, we couldn't go in his house because COVID was spiking but big time at the time. Well, because it was fucking cold out, that's why. By the time it got warm, it went all the way down, and until now we never heard a major story about it again. So I'm noticing a trend. So in like middle of winter, we heard a major story about it. And then after that, it calmed down and never heard about it again. So I'm hoping that's the case this time, where eventually after whoever has it, you know, that I know in the neighborhood or at work or wherever, like, you know, after they recover, that eventually it calms down. It calms down again. I don't think it's as bad now as it was when it was spiking up this past winter. Which I'm hoping that's the case, and if it isn't, maybe it'll slow down quicker now than it did in the winter. But man, maybe that's why barely anybody's out now. That's why barely anybody's out. So we'll find someone to wish happy birthday Anna Grace. I mean, even if it's just one person, I'll take it. I mean, it
better than nothing. Well, if there's any like landing destination we can go, at least this make one long ass, well, semi-long ass stop before we park the bus early. We'll go back to the Beals and, you know, chill with them, and maybe we'll see Mallory and say, you know, Richard, happy, what was it, her, Kevin Harvick, like I said, I'm trying to figure out, I'll have to double check on Facebook if it was her Kevin Harvick 29th or Jeff Green 30th. I mean, both children's cars from back when I was little. All right, so I had a chance to check it out, like Kevin LePage. It was 1992, so that means it's her Jeff Green 30th birthday. So we're gonna go back over there and make another bonus trip and see if we can, you know, make our birthday wishes and have her be the perfect person to say happy birthday to Anna Grace Barlow for what was her Ricky Rudd 28th. This is a friend who I have not seen in God knows how long, since the 2017 Nabria Fairgrounds. Lena, how do you say your last name? How do you pronounce it?
Sistolo.
That's a fucking difficult one. So today we're out here 2 days late celebrating Anna Grace Barlow's Ricky Rudd 28th birthday. And so therefore, it was actually Sunday, Lena, but it was a fucking monsoon here all day long. So therefore, I was going to watch the New England 300 at Loudoun, New Hampshire, but I slept through it. Luckily for me, sleeping through it saved me because I didn't have to see both of my favorite drivers, the Dillons, have bad days where Ty was the first caution with a couple other cars and Austin had a caution flag fiasco with Brad Keselowski. So therefore, it was good to see him. Let's sing happy birthday to Anna Grace Barlow.
I can't sing.
Do you just want to say it instead?
I'll say happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to Anna Grace Barlow. Okay, this is Michelle.
I'm her friend.
Michelle, I'm... Do you want to sing, Michelle?
Yeah, let's sing.
Okay, we'll count to 28 NASCAR style. 25, 26, 27, Rudd.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Anna Grace. Happy birthday to you.
2 days late, but hey, better late than never.
Hey, happy birthday, Anna Grace.
Ricky Rudd, 28. That's how old I am. I turned 28 the day after Valentine's Day.
I'm 19.
Jeremy Mayfield, what about you?
What?
Well, I'm
19.
Mayfield, yes. Even though Kyle Petty was my driver, I loved Mayfield like a motherfucker back in the day. With the 19 Mountain Dew Dodge and the green front valence and the green roof number, which explains why I was angry when he wasn't in Chase for the Cup 2005. Mm. Yeah. Anything else you guys want to say?
No,
I don't think so.
Yo, oh, this was fucking awesome. You're either with me or opposed me. Bring it in. Would you loosen up? Would you? Well, that was something. Man, I haven't seen Lena since the 2017 Berea Fair. Like, holy shit, that was unexpected and unplanned. And that's the way it should be. That's what makes it more fun and special. And we did a TikTok, so you probably might... Oh, duh. I threw that in between the clip we filmed and the one I'm filming now. So I'm a fucking idiot. But anyway, at least we got some excitement and somebody to say happy birthday to Anna Grace. And, you know, 2 days late, but hey, better late than never, as they always say. But... Okay, I know there's not been much people out because some of the neighbors have contracted you know what, but that's understandable. Hopefully, like I said, this shit will slow down faster than it did over time at the midwinter, you know, when things are getting crazier. But usually when it's warm, midsummer, it starts calming down a little bit. But anyway, all we gotta do is continue to pray and hope for the best. So speaking of Jeff Green and the number 30, we got a 30% battery left. So we usually try to go down to 10 before we usually have to park the bus because, you know, once you want to go home and charge your phone, you sit there for a long ass time, you know, waiting for it to charge to a respectable amount of battery. Your ass wants to stay in the house because we've had this discussion like 100 times probably. You have to keep a rhythm going if you want to continue to stay outside for as long as possible till you reach, like, the regular scheduled time limit. You know, if a neighbor sends you home,
I'm not talking about just me. This is just generally speaking for anybody out there who has had this experience in their lives and probably still has it now in my shoes at my age. Well, usually there's a certain time limit, you know, like a curfew or, you know, unlimited, I know your own unlimited custom curfew where that's like my dad used to do, where my dad back in the day, even on Sandhurst until all some stuff that I will not get into on the interwebs happened over there. And then of course here when, you know, but during the days of some stuff, other personal stuff in my life, I'll never get into on the interwebs. He just let me would stay out here until I decided it was time for me to come myself to come home. Whether it got dark out, or the lights came on, the street lights came on, combination of both, or if like a neighbor sent me home, or if I felt like I wanted to come home, as long as it was a reasonable time for myself. You see, I don't have that app anymore, even though I'm 28. Because that was back when I was in school and I didn't have to have any like true adult responsibilities. Now that I have a job, even though it's not like a serious job, like my mom always says, even though I try to make it something less with, you know, I will admit, such a BS excuse, I try to make it legitimate. A job is a job, so therefore we have to be responsible whenever we have some fun at home outside of work. So we just have to be a little cautious. Not, I wouldn't say careful, I would say cautious. So therefore, we have to have a time limit set by the family. I know if my dad were around, he probably wouldn't care. Because, you know, compared to all the shit that went on on Sandhurst back in the day, this place has basically been drama-free, you know. We've had a couple minor incidents, but because of the people we've surrounded ourselves with are better than what people surround ourselves back in the Brook Park era, where we usually like give ourselves maybe a couple days in between, maybe even as up to a week, and then we talk it out. We talk it out like real boys, girls, men, and women, and we're if we don't kill a friendship off, like, you know, we did over there, we don't do none of that stuff. We just give ourselves some time to cool off, like a couple of days maximum, maybe even a week. And then we come to each other. Like, most of the time I'll come to the person first, or it's more I come to the person first. Most of the time they never come to me if they want to, you know, talk it out. But nonetheless, we talk it out like real men, women, boys, and girls. And it's all done. And, you know, the beef is in the rearview mirror. And it'll be... are back to our regularly scheduled friendship lives like nothing happened. So when you have a job like me and are still relatively young as I am, being Ricky Rudd 28, you have to have like a certain time limit going. You have to have a time limit. So last year was 8:30. Last year when I was finishing my time at EOVC, it was 8:30. Now that I'm 1 year later, it's up to 9:00, full year triad, probably switching to ViaQuest by next Wednesday. Who fucking knows? But I was jokingly saying, but I could be serious too. I'm noticing a trend pattern developing. So if we keep this up going into next year, I could see us, our time limit in the summertime getting bumped up to 9:30. I don't know if that's going to happen, but it's a possibility, of this trend and pattern that's developed the last 2 years, but maybe going to the three next, but we'll find out. But yeah, you have to have a time limit, come in as soon as possible, maybe 8:39, 10:00, not 10:00, that's way too fucking late. 8:30, 9:00, 9:30, and maybe the latest. Hell, I usually see the whole neighborhood empty and completely empty and dead silent by the time it's 10:00. Unless it's like a special event, that's going on around here, like a holiday or a celebration or any kind of special occasion in general. That's like the only time. Other than that, a regular night, it's already quiet and silent by the time I get to 10:00. Nobody's ever out this late. So this way, if you come home at a reasonable time, no matter if you set it up yourself, if your family trusts you, if your family sets it up, no matter how old you are, it gives you enough time to take a shower, do some, occasionally if you're like me, shave, cut your nails, eat your dinner, drink your soda, ice cold soda, all that good stuff, and refresh and everything. Watch your favorite YouTubers, do their thing. You upload your own video just like I do. you know. But the other thing I was talking about is you have to keep a rhythm going no matter what the time limit is. So, you know, until like, you know, if you, you know, the time limits are usually set by your family with a certain time they want you home. Or, you know, if they trust you to come home on your own, you can come home anytime you want. Like you feel like you want to come home. If a neighbor sends you home, or if it gets dark, or you know, the street light comes on, or a combination of those things. As long as you, like, you know, are responsible and make responsible decision by yourself, you're fine. But yeah, wonder who that is. I don't know that person, but you know, making responsible, you gotta make the right decisions. Oh yeah, no, I remember what I was saying. You have to keep a rhythm going. You have to keep a rhythm going, because if you stay in the house, go in the house for any reason, like, you know, if you're taking a break, like a drink break or a bathroom break, you gotta like keep moving as quick as possible. You gotta keep moving as quick as possible. Keep that rhythm going, because if you sit in the house for too long, like waiting for your phone to charge long enough time, you're gone. Your ass wants to stay the hell in, so you gotta keep that going. So you gotta keep it going as fast as possible. So, you know, once you're in for a long enough period of time, your body wants to stay in the whole time. So, that's a little pep talk I wanted to bring to you guys as we're, you know, recording this jumbo sized birthday tribute for Anna Grace Barlow for what was her Ricky Red 20th birthday 2 years ago, 2 years ago, two fucking days ago. What the fuck am I saying? Oh my God, like, that was a definition of a brain blunder fart, if you ask me. Okay, we got a Jeremy Mayfield on 19% battery as Demon Dobie's guarding the crotch of doom. And look who it is, it's Ninja Fighter and Sexy Mama. Next. Yep, back in fucking action, bitches. I know, that was so random of me. I'm sorry. I couldn't fucking resist. Like, oh my God. But anyway, we have a 19% battery until we have to park this motherfucking bus. So, anyway, if we do not get any more birthday wishes for Anna Grace Barlow today, that's perfectly fine with me, because I got something really good that I wanted. Yep, that's Big Sam's mom, you know, Abby's grandmother. Yep. I can't remember when the fuck we met. I know we have the pictures on Facebook. Not with her, but with, you know, her daughter-in-law, you know, Big Sam's wife, Mama Chris. Well, I have to look that up, but that was a good day. That was a good day. Any day I see Abby or Chris over there is a damn good day. I love them both dearly with all my whole heart. Doesn't look like the gifts are hanging out today. Oh, well. I mean, not everybody is gonna... As is the case for everyone else other than me, you're not always gonna make it outside every single day. Like, not just me, and it doesn't just apply to me. It applies to anybody in this damn neighborhood. I mean, hell, I haven't seen most of the big names out. I mean, Crotchet Doom and Jerry Springer Lady are Little Lady Germifier's softball game. That was on TikTok, so I figured, shit, no Crotchet Doom tonight. I mean, Cutie Pie. Who knows what the fuck they are, you know, Dommy Baby, the Love Doctor, and a nicknameless Vinny. Well, when he was younger, we had something, had a colorful name for him, but to keep all the commentary respectful, I am not going to tell you guys that shit. No, I'm not going to get into that fucking story. On the fucking internet, because people I know in real life, including him, watch my videos, and some of them even do the videos with me. So in order to keep that going, I'm not gonna bring up old shit from back when they were different people. I'm not talking about just Vinny. I'm talking about people I've known in Reyzorz since I got here, you know. But was I like that too? Yeah, but as you get older, it's basically something that's called growing. Growing up, whatever, you know. Anyway, let's go see how Mo's doing, but if not, we'll just go back. We'll just park the bus. We'll just kill ourselves and go back.
Okay, this is the last cutscene we're doing before the outro. We're at Brett Bodine percent battery 11, so we're finally our first trip since 4th of July, maybe the week after that, to my main man, Mo Mohammed Mustafa. Go subscribe to him. Link is in the description. There he is. Yep. And you know, there's a name connection I have actually made to you since with your full name. There was a guy who with the last name Mohammed who played for the Spurs when I was younger.
Oh, yeah?
Last Nazi Mohammed. N-A-Z-R and then Mohammed. That was his last name. So whenever I see your full name pop up, I think of him. Because, you know, name connections.
Yeah.
Name connections. He wore number 2 like Jared Jackson did when during the Fiesta logo days with the Alamo Dome. And then when, you know, the reason Ray Nazi got there was because we had Malik Rose from 1997 till we traded him away to New York in 2005 for Nazi Mohammed, and that's how Malik missed out on winning the Spurs' third ring. He missed out on getting a third ring that, you know, because that Spurs ended up winning because he got traded to New York middle of that same season, and Nazi got that ring instead. Because Malik won 2 of them with the Spurs in 99 and 03. Had he, you know, he stayed, he would have won 3. And that video of him leaving San Antonio was really, really, really sad. It was like, you know, it was the San Antonio news cast that, you know, him thanking all the people that helped him, made him who he is all the years he was there, and before he took off on the plane to New York. I went from service on that video like years after it happened. At the time, it broke my heart because, of course, I was little. But if I were to look at that now, it's like, well, that's something that I can look back on and just, you know, like reminisce about how sad that was at the time. As an adult, I really wouldn't care now, considering we're not the same squad that we were when Tim was there. Yep, name connections.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's it. We're done for the day, and that'll do it for Anna Grace Barlow's jumbo-sized birthday tribute for her Ricky Rudd 28th birthday. Oh, here's Richard Dawson, lady. Go subscribe to her channel. Link is in the description. Check her out like Kevin LePage. But so glad we finally got this shit over with. I mean, at least we got some excitement. I guess the bit being jumbo size is gonna live up to how long it, you know, it's length, time length after all. Jumbo size. So therefore, Anna Grace, I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you show Abigail, Liza, and your mom, you know, Pollyanna, and your boyfriend, Andrew Colicchio, and all of his buddies. So I've had this plan for months. And even though it came 2 days late, we did the damn thing. I know tomorrow is going to be an upload. I don't know what the fuck it's going to be, but as long as the weather can cooperate for as long as possible, maybe we'll do a Tim Duncan Can I Recreate episode. We already did Garra Accioni Sudor for the week, so none of that shit, unless somehow by luck of the draw it comes naturally. But as long as I'm actually trying to provide you certain things, I'm not going to fucking try it unless anything in general comes to me naturally. So unless it comes to me naturally, no Garra Accioni Sudor. So, but if it somehow rains by 5 o'clock tomorrow, like it's supposed to, then of course I'd do that. I decided to change up the plan. I originally was going to bring that girl Lele's, my reaction videos outdoors, but since I have to keep that, you know, rhythm, you got to keep a rhythm going. You got to trust your instinct. That got me on little things taught us. Record Lele like we did last week, this week and every Thursday and every Thursday this week and beyond. Finish your time outside and then watch it when you go inside. It's better to, like, you know, watch it, record it instead of real time. That you could skip to the commercial and get all the names of the actors that are in the episode as the characters you see on your screen. And Friday is the usual Villains of Valley View, Ultraviolet, Black Scorpion, and Bunked content. And guess who updated their Facebook finally? Haley. And she updated it to single, so I have a fucking chance on Thursday. So there's a possibility it might be a Michael Waltrip 15th installment of Mark's presentations, you know. I'll probably record that before Disney Channel Night in America, Bugged Villains of Valley View, Ultraviolet and Black Scorpion. I probably won't upload it till Friday. But if the shit doesn't work and you don't see it, I kind of gave that away. That if you don't see it, you'll know why. Then you're being the reason the shit didn't work. But Gotta keep your fingers crossed, pray on it, hope for the best. And Saturday, maybe we'll do a Tim Duncan kind of recreate. And Sunday, if it rains, you know, Pocono 500, Pennsylvania 500, whatever the fuck you want to call it, even though it's 400 miles now. But anyway, let's get the hell out of here. Have a good night tonight and a better day tomorrow. Life will give you a lot of lows, but when you hit a high, enjoy it. It ain't for the weak. Goddamn, be you. You have to try harder to do less. You can't deport a dream. Sometimes the worst things in life lead to the best things. Always bet on the side of love. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. Sometimes you just gotta be present. You never fail until you stop trying and never pace to worry too much about things. We're not here for a long time. We're here for a good time. So take care, everyone. Good night. And once again, happy belated Ricky Rudd 28th birthday to Anna Grace Barlow, Lisa Levine on the Goldbergs and ABC, which sadly could not find any clips of on the interwebs whatsoever. But most important of all, Brittany Lovewell on The Big Leap on Fox. See you later, everyone. It's Brittany, bitch.